story starts at the climax. We find that time's lapse, don't mind that. It's kinda like a nightcap, full of divine acts. We zoom in the lens on Christ's agony in the garden. Doom for his friends, his tragedy for our pardon. For seeing the Father's cup of wrath that has him stifled and weak. He's sweating blood with his disciples asleep. The Prince of Peace knows the beef shall increase since the thief approaches with the soldiers and the chief priests. His arrest is not just, neither is the trial. While Jesus being treated foul, he sees Peter's denial. He's sent to Pilate, to Herod, back to Pilate. The violence of humanity at its finest. So now he stands before the crowd, doomed to die. An angry mob who's yelling out, crucify. The way they treat the Lord of glory is debasing, it's foul. But you miss the point if you don't see your face in the crowd.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
My Lord.
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
My Lord.
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
My Lord.
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there?
Man, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Yo, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Tremble. This story starts at the climax. We find that time's lapse, don't mind that. It's kinda like a nightcap, full of divine acts. We zoom in the lens on Christ's agony in the garden. Doomed for his friends, it had to be for the pardon and delivery from misery of kids who speak wickedly, sinfully, inwardly slick with the iniquity. We see disciples sleep and mock today with a lot to say, but we do the same thing when we don't watch and pray. Like Judas, we sell Christ out to get the treasure, whether it's the cheddar or forbidden pleasures. Like the chief priest, we want Christ to surrender, but we want him out the way when he doesn't fit our agenda. Like Peter, we have misplaced fleshly confidence, but we'll deny the Lord when faced with deadly consequence. Like Herod, we're curious about Christ because he's famous, but we quickly get bored with him if he doesn't entertain us. Like Pilate, we see Christ and find nothing wrong with him, but when the world chooses the wicked, we go right along with him. Despite his kindness, we seek to do our maker violence, the fallenness of humanity at its finest. So now he stands before the crowd, he's doomed to die. An angry mob who's yelling out, crucify. The way they treat the Lord of glory is debased and it's foul. But you miss the point if you don't see your face in the crowd.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
My Lord.
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
My Lord.
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
My Lord.
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there?
Were you there?
Man, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Yo, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Tremble. This story starts at the climax. We find that time's lapse, don't mind that. It's kinda like a nightcap, full of divine acts. We zoom in the lens on Christ's agony in the garden. Doomed for his friends, his tragedy for our pardon. For seeing the Father's cup of wrath that has him stifled and weak. He's sweating blood with his disciples asleep. The Prince of Peace knows the beef shall increase since the thief approaches with the soldiers and the chief priests. His arrest is not just, neither is the trial. While Jesus being treated foul, he sees Peter's denial. He's sent to Pilate, to Herod, back to Pilate. The violence of humanity at its finest. So now he stands before the crowd, he's doomed to die. An angry mob who's yelling out, crucify. The way we treat the Lord of glory is debased and it's foul. Ashamed I bow, because I see my face in the crowd.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
My Lord.
Were you there?
I was there.
Were you there?
I was there.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
My Lord.
Were you there?
I was there.
Were you there?
I was there.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
My Lord.
Were you there?
I was there.
Were you there?
I was there.
Man, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Yo, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Tremble.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord? The old Negro spiritual asks. And we must answer yes. We were there. Not as spectators only, but as participants, guilty participants, plotting, scheming, betraying, bargaining, and handing him over to be crucified. We may try to wash our hands of responsibility like Pilate, but our attempt will be futile. before we can begin to see the cross as something done for us, leading us to faith and worship, we have to see it as something done by us, leading us to repentance. Only the man or woman who is prepared to own his share in the guilt of the cross may claim his share in its grace.